was my rock. His wife did. She lost her faith for a while, but he continued. And what he is saying with, you know, this is a staffer of his told me a story that when they're traveling, when he was vice president, they would always, she put it, had to find a priest so he could have a service, a private service, no matter where they were. Because it is so, so important to him. It is the ritual. It's kind of a refreshing of your mind in many ways, taking you out of your job that you have to do. And it is so important to him. And it is so not something he is doing as a performance art. It is something he really believes in.
But let's not ignore the ritual, the secular ritual.
Yeah.
You know, the ritual of honoring his even his political opponents and saying we are all part of this.
Air Force One about to take off from Joint Base Andrews, the Trump family on board, then the plane load of grievances, of grudges, going to Florida, a new administration taking over.
Yeah, I mean, you can just feel a big weight coming off the shoulders of a lot of people. I mean, it's been a really nightmarish 4 years for a lot of people. And just the idea, I mean, listen, as this plane takes off and they go do whatever they're going to do, it's exactly the case that the country is on its knees. It's been on its knees grieving. It's been on its knees hurting. Now it's going to be on its knees praying with this new president. And we can stand up together now. We can stand up together now.
And surreally, the soundtrack that we continue to hear throughout these scenes is surreal, perhaps surreally appropriate.
What's wrong with Gloria?
Let's just watch in silence as this Air Force One takes off and the Trump family leaves Washington, leaves the seat of power.
Yes. It was my way.
And inside the church, the Biden family,